Hello students, once again I am here with the chapter Basic Geometrical Ideas. So students, in this chapter, in previous classes we have learned about lines, line segments, curve line, open curve, closed curve, such type of things we have learned. So today we will be learning about angles. So how we can name the angles, naming of angles, types of angle, these things we will learn. First of all, we will learn how what are the angles, how we name the angles. So students, let's start. In the figure, students, you can find some diagrams. Here you can see the diagrams, students. Students, these all are called angles. These all are angles, students. So that means inclination of these two arm. Now let me show with the pencil, with the help of just these. Can you see, students? These are the two arms. This is called angle. That means this inclination of these two lines. Suppose if I put it like this over here, this shows the inclination of the line. This makes an angle. Now if I show it over there, this is the inclination of this line. This shows the angle. So you can incline any like this also. I can incline. So this is the inclination of the line. So which part will be the angle? This part will be the angle, students. So that means this part, that way this portion is called the angles. These are called arms. These are the arms of the angles. The inclination of these arms forms the angle. Remember, the inclination of the arms forms an angle. So students, these are the inclination of the arms, and these all are arms. This is AB and BC, DE and EF are the arms of the angle. Now students, how we will name the angle. There are many ways to name the angle. First one is angle B. Suppose angle B, we can name it. Angle B means this is the angle. Angle E means this is the angle. Now students, there is another way to name the angle. Like this also we can name angle. This is the symbol of angle. Why I give this symbol? Because this is the angle. So that's why I have to give this symbol like this. So angle A, B and C. So A, B and C. That means the letter which is in the middle, that represents the angle. Remember, the letter in the middle represents this angle. So this same thing I can represent it like this. Angle C, B, A. Here also letter is in the middle is B. So it represents angle B. So in this way we can represent the angle, students. So now let me draw a diagram. Let me give you an example from your textbook how we represent the angle. Let me draw a diagram and let me show you. Now students, now suppose this is the diagram. This is an example from a textbook. I've taken from the textbook. So this is the diagram from textbook. See, this is the diagram. So let me write A, this is A, this is B, this is C and this is D. So now students, if I have to name this angle, how will I name the angle? Okay, so now the name of this angle is, angle A, D, C. A, D, C, students. A, D, C represent which angle? A, B, C. That means it represents this angle. See, these are the arms, AD and DC. See, which angle I have represent? Angle D I have represent. So D is in the middle. See, D is in the middle. Now, next one. Next, this is the angle. So how will I represent this angle? I will represent like this. D, C, B. So this is the angle, students. Now see, C is in the middle. C is in the middle, students. D, C, B. The same angle I can represent like this. Angle B, C, D. See, here also C is in the middle, students. See? So I can represent like this. B, C, D. That means this is the angle. So suppose I have to represent this angle. So how will I represent? Angle D, D, A, A, B. So in this way I will represent D, A, B. In this way I will represent the angle, students. So students, so the same thing I can represent like this. Angle B, A, D. So in this way, I will represent angle D, A, B, angle B, A, D. Either D, A, B or you can write, or B, A, D you can write. That means A is in the middle in both the cases. So you can say D, A, B, or you can say B, A, D. That means this angle is represented. Now, if I find this angle, how will I write? This angle I will write is like this. This second angle I can write like this, students. Angle C, B, A. C, B, A. That means this is the representation of the angle. Or we can write A, B, C. This is the angle. So, this is the way we represent the angle, students. So, hope students, you have come to know that how we can represent the angle. So, whenever it comes a figure like this, in this type of figure, how we name the angle. So, naming the angle, this is the perfect method to name the angle. We can write as angle B, we can write angle C, we can write angle D, we can write angle A. But actually, this is the proper method to name the angle. Hope, students, you have understood this. Now, students, let me go to one more example. Let me go to one more example, students. Hope you have understood this. How to name the angles. Now, see, students, one more example. Suppose this is the diagram. This is A, this is B, and this is C. So this is E, D, this is suppose F, and this is suppose G. Now, these D and F are the interior of the angle, and this G is in the exterior of the angle. So now, if I ask you, how will you name the angle B? First question, how will you name the angle B? So we can name this angle B also like this, but students, don't name it like this. So you can name it like this, angle A, B, C. In this way, you can name the angle, angle A, B, C. That means A, B, C we can name it. Or we can name it like this also, angle C, B, A. In this way also we can name it, students. That means the angle which we represent, that letter should be in the middle, C, B. I have represented angle B. Angle B is in the middle. Here also angle B is in the middle. So students, whichever angle I will represent, that angle has to be in the middle, students. So students, now if I ask you, name the points, interior of angle A, B, C. So if I ask you to name the points interior of A, B, C, it means that what can we say? Interior of A, B, C, which is the point is in the interior of A, B, C? And D and F. Which is the point is in the exterior of A, B, C? G is the point which is exterior of A, B, and C. So hope, students, how we name the angle, you have understood. But remember one important thing. So, if you, while naming the angle, suppose you want to name this angle, if you write ABC, ABC, this is wrong. But this is called vertex. This vertex, that means this symbol of angle. Actually, this portion, we symbolize like this. That means, this means we are representing this angle. That means what? B says that you are representing this one. But this symbol means you are representing this angle. Understood, students? This symbol means this is the symbol of angle. And which angle are you representing? You are representing angle B. That means B is in the middle. So you are representing angle B. Or we can write like this also, angle C, A, B. This also we can write, students. Hope, students, you have understood this one, how to name the angle. So this type of sums you are going to get either in Google Classroom or WhatsApp. So you try to do the students, try to do those sums. So once sum, let me show you one more example, students. your homework you are going to get in either in Google Classroom or in WhatsApp. You just check it, students. You will get information. So now, suppose this is the point A, B, this point is C. I have represented A, this is B, and this C. Suppose this point is D. Now I have to name this angle B. If I write angle A, B, C, is it correct? Or can I write angle D, B, C? Which one is correct, students? Actually, which angle I have represented? I have represented this angle. Here I have written A, B, this is A, B, C. Here I have written D, B, C. That means I am representing the same angle. That means these both are correct. You can write, if you get such type of points, if you write A, B, C, that is also correct. If you write D, B, C, this is also correct. Both are correct. Remember, students. So, hope students, you have understood how we represent the angles. So, students, you please go through the video properly. And if you have any doubts regarding this, you please let me know. I'll try to make it more simple. So, students, angle is nothing but the inclination of the arms, as I show with the help of the pen. Angle is nothing but this is the inclination of angle is nothing but inclination of the lines. So, how those two lines are inclined each other, that is called angle. So, how these two, see, now I have written like this. How these two are inclined each other, this is called makes an angle, students. So, hope students, you have understood this, and how we name the angle, that also you have understood. So, if you have any doubts, if you have any, if you need any clarification regarding this, you please let me know, students. I'll try to make it more simple. Hope students, you will do it. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.